Thanks, Shay. My name is Chad Taylor, Chadlantis. Joined by me is Dylan, Dillsepticon Schneider. We're going to be playing League of Legends today between the Armada and Adversary team, which the Adversary is we're trying to brand themselves as like the villain of the match this day. Welcome back to the Battle for the Boulevard. Next up, we're going to have Esports at University Central Florida, Esports at UCF Gold, Esports at UCF Black up against each other. See who the representative for UCF is going to be. Thanks, Bradley and Shay. We're going to go ahead and look at some replays here in just a moment, just to see all of the action that happened in that game. I'm really looking forward to seeing those fights like around Dragon, some of those ganks happening, and that Qiyana outplay against the entire team of Armada Gray was amazing to see.
I'm dying to see that one again.
Absolutely. What we're going to do right now is we're going to send it over to Shay on the floor to go ahead and hand out the prizes for competing teams today. Shay, it's off to you. Just a quick tidbit about University of Central Florida. It's actually the largest enrollment in Florida, one of the largest in the country, and they actually have 650 different programs for student clubs, things like that, part of the UCF Gaming Nights as well. Set up a lot of things for the students, one of which being esports at UCF.
That's amazing. I actually didn't know that.
Well, there you go. Now you know. We're here for you. That ult charge grabbed them. Might be a showstopper happening later on. Rod can't find the killer at CP2, taking on the enemy offer. Huge opportunity for Renegades. 4v2 on the map. Spike is down. We know where it is. 20 seconds remaining. Retro finds food. All down to Crashies. He can't do it. CP2 closes it out. And that's going to be Renegades moving on in the playoffs. Goodbye and farewell, T1. Your day is over. Renegades range triumphant in this match in overtime. Wow. Keglenek. What a match we got to end the day on in the group stages.
But even then, that flank is still down, timer's ticking, Randy Savage finds Brett, and Chad, it's a 2v3.
Yeah, this is looking really good for Renegades. Fighting back, Winston and Bergie finishing it off. That's going to be a defuse. A point charge going over to Resurrection for Bergie. Renegades, that was looking like a tough retake for them, but they just fight through it. They find those picks, that kill onto Brax's flank, just sniffing out that maybe somebody would be coming back around there. I believe that was Rainy that got that kill. That was honestly huge. I saw Brax on that flank. I'm thinking, man, if Brax gets his kill, that's going to be a round over for T1, even though Renegades have been finding some kills themselves. But once that happened, once that shutdown occurred, you feel that just revitalized spirit from Renegades. You feel that confidence coming through, and they just closed out the round solidly. T1 fell apart. Round lead back to Renegades as quickly as they lost it. They got it right back the round after. 10-9 going to round 20. Best of one. Losing team. They go out. You can feel that tension building. T1 being very slow on their approach. They're not being very reckless. Not just throwing themselves on the sites like we saw Renegades do earlier on this game. T1 being very methodical. They did a great job getting onto B site there, but they just couldn't hold it. And that flank from Brax. Brax keeps doing these big flanks. Starting off at A site, doing a flank through middle, going into B heaven. But Renegades is ready for it. He's done it so often. Renegades just has that read. Brax can't find success doing that. Brax needs to do something different this round. And the rest of T1 needs to clutch up, get this round win, or they're out for the day, out for the tournament. Yeah, Randy found that trap wire, spreading that frenzy around. Crashy's doing the same. Brax on the A site. They said, what we're going to do? As CP2 finds a kill on Crashy's, AJK answers right back. And it's like Christmas morning on the board. 1-1 now is Bergie versus Brax. Can Brax clutch it up for T1 right now for everything? Bergie gets a revive on Winston, the clutch player for the team. But they couldn't get the defuse in time. Brax clutches it. 4K on the round. We call him out. Can't do the rotate from A to B anymore. What to do instead? Just send it through A. That's Brax's domain. Gets the 4K. Ties it up into overtime. T1's hopes are alive. Renegade's still in it. And the overtime do or die moment for these teams right now. Yeah, exactly what I was talking about. They just try to figure out where TSM is going, because TSM's really good at just find that pick and then exploding. Just kind of like they did that last round on A. They just couldn't close it out very effectively. But now you can see what Homeless is doing, very back lane, like you were calling out. So when the push finally happens, they're able to rotate as a team and have a good like 5-on-5 fight. But Wardell is not letting that happen at all. Getting that first kill on Glassy, but the response is happening on both sides. TSM getting the better of it so far. Yeah. That's just unfortunate positioning for both Lasky and Def that game. Lasky in hell for heaven, or for A, I mean, and just Recon Bolt finds him out. You kind of, you see him on screen there. He looks at the Recon Bolt. It's kind of like, Well, I'm done, boys. I'm out of here. The whole enemy team of TSM's on A side, all ready to swarm on the wolf pack, ready to go. So he didn't have much left time left on the world there. And then Death alone as Haze. We're not clinic. A 3K. Make that 4. Almost gets the ace. Oh, that was so close. Haze, you're a madman. That was so beautiful. But Cutler able to just finish it off for the team. 12-10. TSM might be just be ending this game really strongly at the very last moment. Now, match point 12-10. And I believe that was our fastest round so far.
Psalm, like the beginning, like potentially the end, in a 1v1 situation. But it's going to be TSM in the very end, with Drone getting the final kill, taking down Homeless.
Yeah, I don't know about the... You know that Drone is in that spot last scene, just a couple seconds ago. I don't agree with pulling out the knife. I kind of get the idea of like when I get to, maybe if they're rotating, get there faster. But that's the last known location a few seconds ago. You want to have your gun out. Like, for sure. Like, you don't know where they're going to rotate to from that kill. And that was just a really unfortunate decision by Psalm there after making so many amazing plays, such as that just kind of ninja defuse moment where he just clutched it up with that hold. But yeah, it's going to be Homeless going down. First game of the group stage here, 0-1 so far. TSM taking the victory, as many expected, but I wouldn't say many expected it to be that close. Homeless is a very strong team, clearly. We just wanted to see what they could do to step up against a team like TSM. And now we kind of know what their capabilities are. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what they can do against the rest of this group. They have to go against Morning Light and Rise, teams that I believe they can take a victory off of if they perform like that, if not better, in those following games.